straight from the arse's mouth,
Right now, I'm an Irie like Mr. Myrie, who generally sits on its veranda reading his diary.
There's nobody else to tell you about Jacob Miller like me. Jacob Miller is from St. Elizabeth. He used to stay with his aunt at 20 Russell Road. Jacob Miller used to live. It was an hotel yard. A lot of people used to go to that hotel there. But I met him like 68, 69 when I used to work at Cox's studio as a printer. When I went to Cox, I used to print labels, you know. I learned three trades at Alpha, you know, music, printing and tile making. Jacob Miller was there, come from Russell Road, and he come to Cox's studio. And when he come to Cox's studio, he fools around the rubbish bin because I put a lot of new records. When I work at Cox's, I hide a lot of records in the rubbish bin because people want Eptones on top of me, Alton Ellis, Jackie Mitten in London. People want all those records from me, and I used to distribute records too. So Jacob used to be a little boy, and Al Campbell. Used to be some little boys come there and they messed around. They know I have record, they take it and they steal it, you know. He wanna be a singer, but that's why he come to the studio. But at that time, he used to hang around with Al Campbell. He used to be like a second singer, to harmonize with Al Campbell. He finally sing some songs with he and Al Campbell for Studio One. We went to a band named The Spell, S-P-E-L-L. That was a band that some rich guy that owned some resource up in Beverly Hills. He decided to form a band and he had some money to buy some very expensive instruments. In those days, a lot of Chinese people own instruments, you know, so I didn't have a drum set for myself. Somebody have to buy a drum set. So we have this band named Spell. So we move this band named Now Generation that used to have Mikey Chung and those guys, and they break up. So they need the Chinese guy that has the band, he needs some musicians. So we went there and play as No Generation too. You know what I mean? We went to Generation Gap too. You know, a lot of people were here, yeah, went to different bands. Then we went in a circle. We were in a circle, want two guys, a drummer and a bassman. So we moved together.
Pipe in a gully, we want to come out in the open, but the breeze can blow it so far away to the north, to the
south. Tired for liquid in a bush, want to smoke it in the open. Yeah man, that's our smoke and drums for Jacob Miller, man, you know what I mean? 80,000 KLCT open shall go down in the Babylon. You know, he sing many songs, but those like are my favorites, you know what I mean?
He
was, I tell you, very heavy to me. If Jacob Miller was alive, he'd give Bob Marley that problem. Like, be like the king of reggae or something. You know, people say Bob Marley's the king of reggae, but Jacob Miller, like, he has everything. Just everything as an artist. He was like big, chubby, and he moves around. And I mean, you know, Jacob Miller is the man that made me meet Michael Manley. He take me to his office to meet the Prime Minister. And he was like, when he went to the Prime Minister, he put his legs on the Prime Minister's chair like that and said, Menelai, I want to meet my Jama, you know. And Michael Manley, you know, you can't call him Menelai. And he wasn't just a liberal Prime Minister. He was, Richie, oh, Jacob, how you do that? You want to sing like Jacob? And Jacob, I was just put on the man's business table, and Michael Mann didn't worry about that. He was just cool, you know. Jacob was his friend, you know what I mean? And I shake his hand. That's how I meet Michael Mann, the true Jacob Miller, you know, man. I remember when he take off a policeman hat off his head, the man took a beer in a concert, and say, I put on his head, A big inspector man say, Rasta man control the Babylon, no. And cause a big confusion on the state, the policeman wanna lock up Jacob Miller and he couldn't lock up Jacob Miller on stage. There were like 60,000 people out there saying, leave the Rasta alone, you know what I mean? He was a real revolutionist, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? So Rasta man don't play for the CIA, you know, just like Bob Marley, you know what I mean? And he was like very forceful, you know what I mean? And he was smart in his lyrics and he has a lovely voice. He can sing like opera. He can. He has an international reggae voice.
In the first month of the 70s, the words of Jack came to us.
1980, I think he died, you know, before Bob Marley, you know what I mean? Oprah already left Bob Marley's studio and going down. I think he has a cane in his hand, and it happened to me one day. There's a cane man by Alfred Chee. Whenever time you're going to 56 Oprah Road, you stop and you buy some cane. And I was there driving, eating the cane, turning the steering like that, and the steering hook between, and the cane hook between the steering. Trust me. And I was going so fast. There's a little thing I ease up for me to touch my brakes. I would go into a wall because I think that happened to Jacob when he was going back. I hear that he was eating some cane or something, going down back to Apache. And the place that he ran into, just leave a little small little dot like this on my finger. Not a big dot. And the steering wheel goes to his chest. You know what I mean? And you know the policeman that take him up in a jeep? I heard that the policeman, he stopped by a bar to take a drink, and Jacob Miller was at the back. I said, oh yeah, the Rasta man in the back here. Yeah. Some Rasta man get crushed and he drink a liquor before him take him to the hospital. Because he's a Rasta. In those days, you know what I mean? It was rough, Rasta. And, I mean, people should know that. To me, he's an icon of Jamaican music in the short time he was there. I really miss them, kind of man. The most time I go to bed, I see them in my vision, you know. I hear them like, when I play my drums on stage sometimes, like I hear Bob Marley say, go on, ass mouth! Ass it, go on! Peter says, hey, better go on, but I ease them up, you know. And Jacob say, hey, ass mouth, but I ramp, you know. Like, you know, you hear all those things in the ears when you're playing on stage, you know what I mean? From all of your colleagues, you know what I mean? And I think we all work together still up to this day, you know what I mean? Jacob Killer Miller, Horsemouth, Mississauga.
A stroke, line with iron from creation.